First of all, I would like to say welcome for everyone. My name is Hakan. I'm working for Mavile Electronic Company. And today I'm going to talk about design and application of fire detection and alarm systems in hotels. Also, I will talk about basic components of the system, detectors, manual call points, sounders, and our references. What is it used for, project principles and applications. We will start with purpose of the webinar and we will move on with hotel fires and the importance of fire detection in hotels, fire protection standard in hotels, detectors, manual call points, sounders and basic components of systems. So what is the purpose of the webinar? It is to provide information on fire risks in hotel buildings and the technologies used in early detection of these risks and their use, to contribute to the knowledge of our colleagues who produce projects, implement and work in hotel buildings. The hospitality industry is one of the most important sectors in our country as well as all over the world. When it comes to hosting guests, we naturally think of accommodation facilities like hotels, motels and resorts. The success of the mentioned industry depends directly on the comfort, health and safety criteria of these facilities like hotels, motels and resorts. Naturally, guests want to comfort, health and safety criteria of the building they live in to be of the same standard all over the world. It is one of the indispensable conditions for the life safety of the guests to detect the earliest possible fires in the buildings of hotels, motels and resorts and to make the necessary warnings, controls and interventions. The importance of the fire detection in hotels. There are many rooms on the floors of the hotel buildings, although this may be noticed early by the residents or employees in the event of possible fire and general areas of hotels. It is not possible to be detected early in the event of fire inside the room. When the room is empty or when the room guests are asleep, there are many fire reasons in the hotel rooms. For example, heating of electrical applications, kettle, TV, hair dryer, adapters, etc. Careless consumption of cigarette products, candles can be shown as many causes of fire, especially for the guests who stay at hotel. The start of fire at night is very dangerous. Therefore, it is very important to detect the fire at the earliest and to make the necessary warnings in controls in other indoor places where there are no permanent people in the hotel buildings. Fires in hotels are evaluated in two categories. It is statically demonstrated that fire occurring in common areas of hotel kitchen, boiler room, garbage processing plant, chimneys, energy rooms and common areas contributed 49.8% of fire occurring in hotels. These fires are described as easy to limit fire and are taken under control in a short time and in a small area. As a result of these fires, it is observed that some material damage occurs. Loss of life does not occur. Minor injuries and poisoning may occur. In addition, it is statistically revealed that it contributes 50.2% of fire in guest rooms, warehouses, and rooms without employees. These fires are described as difficult to limit fire. These fires can lead to undesirable consequences such as injury, loss of life, and large material damage. Basic components of system, as I mentioned before, these are detectors, manual call points, sounders, and panels. Okay, let's talk about detectors. Basic effects such as smoke, heat, and flame occurs as a result of fire. Detectors used for fire detection are produced with features that detect one or more of these effects together. In the occurrence of fire, the order of the formation of the effects, the fire may vary depending on the characteristic of the flammable materials in the area. For example, since there will be a burning in the fire of wood or cotton, first of all, smoke occurs, the temperature increase, and the last exacerbation occurs. In the fire of flammable liquid, firstly, heat increase and the formation of smoke after the flame occurs. Therefore, it is necessary to determine the types of substances that can be burned in a possible fire in the environment and their effects in case of fire. In addition to this, we can decide on the type of detector we will detect the fire by considering the factors such as ceiling height, the effects of the ventilation system, the ambient condition of the neighborhoods, and the possibility of false alarms. Let's talk about optical smoke detectors. It is suitable to use optical smoke detectors in hotel rooms, general places where there is no moisture and dust. In the hotel rooms, the exit halls of bathroom, toilet section can generally be exposed to water vapor. False alarms may occur if a detector is used in these sections. In this sense, it is ideal to position the smoke detectors above the bed area. And let's talk about optical smoke detector detection principle. There is a IR LED goes from transmitter. In normal condition, it is not going through the transmitter, photodiode is the receiver, sorry. But in case of fire, inside of the smoke detector, it will fill with smoke particles and the IR LED will crash the smoke particles and it will change the direction and it will go through the receiver. Then the detector will detect the fire alarm signal. And the optical smoke detector placement should be like this. There should be no blind area. As you can see in this picture, there is no blind area. It is also covered with smoke detectors. The diameter of the detection area is 6.2 meter. And the detector to detector should be maximum 8.8 meter. Also, a smoke detector covers a 6.2 meter radius circle area. Detectors for an array of square detectors in the open area can be up to 8.8 meter apart from each other and up to 4.4 meter from a wall or a large obstacles. As you can see in this picture. In cases where the width of the corridor is less than 2 meters, if the smoke detectors are placed at maximum 12.5 meter gap, the maximum distance to the wall should be 6.2 meter. If the difference between the top and the bottom of the sloping ceiling is greater than 60 centimeters. The ceiling is considered sloped and the detectors are mounted by increasing the radius values for each degree of ceiling slope by 1%. Radius values can be increased by up to 25%. Okay, let's talk about beam detectors and their detection principles. Normally, the beam sent from transmitter reaches the receiver fully. In case of fire, the beam intensity sent from transmitter decreases when it reaches the receiver. And the detector will go into alarm if the reduction is less than or equal to the user set alarm level for 6 or 8 seconds. Let's talk about beam detector placement. Beam type smoke detectors consist of one receiver and one transmitter. Receiver and transmitter should see each other in maximum 100 meter distance. The distance of, as you can see, the meter maximum level, maximum distance. The distance of the IR beam of the beam type smoke detectors to the wall or any obstacle should be minimum 50 centimeters. If there are concern about the impact of stratifications when the detectors are mounted on the ceiling, additional angle beam detectors may be considered appropriate. When the detectors are not within 10% zone, the maximum horizontal distance between the two detectors should be 25% of installation height. Beam detectors are generally used for the high ceiling buildings. As you can see, the range of the height 9 meter to 12 meter area from the ground. Okay, let's talk about heat detector. There are three types of heat detector: temperature effect and fixed heat detectors. Detection of temperature effect and temperature rise rate heat detector, and both combined heat detectors. That means it is working with a fixed heat detector principle and temperature rise rate principle, both of them. What is the fixed heat detector? That means if the ambient temperature reaches 60 degree Celsius, the detector will detect the fire alarm signal. For the temperature rise rate detector, if the temperature increase in 1 minute more than 30 Celsius, the detector will detect an alarm signal. But as I said, it should be increased in 1 minute. And for the combined detector, combined heat detector, that will be working with both principle. Okay, let's talk about heat detector placement. A heat detector covers a 4.5 meter radius circle area. To avoid blind points among coverage areas detectors, coverage areas should be overlapping as shown in the figure above. As you can see, the overlapping areas in here, here, and here. Thus, every detector covers a square of 6.4 meter to 6.4 meter. That means the sum of the total area is 40 meters square. In cases where the width of the corridor is less than 2 meters, if the smoke detectors are placed at maximum, 9 meter gap, the maximum distance to the wall should be 4.5 meters. In cases where the corridor width is more than 2 meters, detectors should be located at a distance about 7 meters. Let's talk about manual call points. Manual call points should be mounted on 1.2 meter average height from the floor, as you can see in this figure. Manual call points must be placed on the escape routes at all doors inside and outside of the escape stairs and all exits leading to the open air, fresh air, and they may also be placed near special hazards and or firefighting equipment. In places with people who have limited mobility, inadequate or requirement special cares, the placement of manual call points may require additional care. The manual call points must be clearly visible, identifiable, and easily accessible. Determination of access distances and locations of manual call points in hotel buildings. The access distance to a manual call point with doors opening directly outside can be maximum 45 meter. Access to any manual call point from any point on the floors can be up to 30 meters. If people with disabilities live in the building, the access distance to a manual call point can be up to 25 meters. In high hazardous locations, the access distance to a manual cold paint should be no more than 16 meters. Let's talk about audible warning devices. In general, in areas where audible alarms may be ineffective, for example, where background noise is excessive or hearing protection is likely to be worn, visual and or tactical tactile alarm devices should be used to support audible alarms. Only in areas that are likely to be used by the hearing impaired should producers be followed into information them about the alarm and or visual or tactile alarm devices should be used to support audible alarms. The sound level should not exceed 118 dB at any point where people can be found. The fire alarm sound should continue for at least 65 dB or 10 dB for more than 30 seconds, whichever is greater. If the alarm is required to alert sleeping people, the minimum sound level at the bedside should be 75 dB. These minimum levels should be reached at any point where the alarm sound should be heard. Bass sounders and mounting bass buzzer applications. It is generally used in hotels. In areas where audible alarm may be ineffective, where background noise is excessive or hearing protection is likely to be worn, visual or tactile alarm devices should be used to support audible alarms. As I mentioned before, the sound level should not exceed 118 dB at any point where people can be found, and the sound used for fire alarm purposes will be the same in all parts of building. On a campus or site with multiple buildings, the alarm sound should be the same for all buildings. Visual fire alarm devices must comply with EN 54 standards. Any visual fire alarm should be clearly visible and should be distinguished from other visual signals used in the building. Visual alarm devices should be numbered and positioned so that they can be clearly seen from any point in the area where they are used. Thank you for your participation. If you have any question, you can ask us from export@mavili.com.tr. Also, please follow us from Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram and YouTube with Mavili Electronic Global account. We are sharing our webinar participation links from our LinkedIn account.